Has Omicron spooked not just the world, but dare I say the World Health Organization? Has it caught you by surprise and in a way spooked your organization?
No, I wouldn't say that, Rajdeep. If you remember, we've been talking about variants from the very beginning. In fact, we set up this technical advisory group to look at viral evolution way back in May of 2020 because we know how viruses behave and we need to be prepared. And in fact, this pandemic is the first time we've had real-time genomic surveillance data to actually inform us about what the virus is doing. Mm-hmm. And this is the biggest unknown in this pandemic. Mm-hmm. So in the past, we've discussed, you know, when will the pandemic end, et cetera, and everything that we do as human beings, we can control, but what the virus does, you know, we cannot entirely anticipate. So I don't think we are surprised or spooked. I don't think we should panic. Mm-hmm. I think we're in a much better position today than we were in the beginning of 2020. Mm-hmm. We have much more knowledge. We have tools, we have diagnostics, we have drugs, we have vaccines, and we know what works in terms of public health measures. And so I think we just need to, we need to go about approaching this with the knowledge base that we have and use it wisely rather than create panic.
Ma'am, you're saying
this is another variant. Yes,
I'm sorry.
Variants of concern we've dealt with them.
I'm sorry to intervene. You've said on 3 occasions already, don't panic. But the fact is, the panic started in a way, some would say, with the World Health Organization saying that it was a variant of concern and doing it almost immediately within days of the virus being, or the variant being detected in South Africa and Botswana. You've taken much longer in the past to declare a variant of concern. Here it happened within a few days. And then the WHO goes on to say, first, it is not yet clear whether the new variant Omicron is more transmissible or severe compared to Delta and other previous variants, but also adds that the global risk is very high based on early evidence and that the mutated coronavirus could lead to surges with severe consequences. That's what spooked the world, ma'am.
Okay, let me explain why it was called a variant of concern and why it is was considered to be high risk. First of all, let's understand that we are in a very high risk state of the pandemic. Okay, that's the baseline. Mm-hmm. As you know, for many weeks, we've seen globally cases increasing, deaths increasing for some time, but now, you know, plateauing, but plateauing at a very high level. And Delta variant is 99% of the variants around the world. So the pandemic itself, we're not in a good situation. We are in a situation of high risk. Mm-hmm. On top of that, you get another unknown, which is a new variant. Mm-hmm. And let's say why the time difference. You know, when the Alpha variant was reported by the UK, it took them months, mm-hmm. took them months to figure out. Similarly, for the other variants, it took a matter of 6, 8, 10 weeks, including the Delta variant, before it was picked up. And then here it's thanks to the strategic and very intelligent type of sequencing that the South African scientists actually employed, where their interest was triggered by a cluster of cases which they thought was unusual. They went in there and sequenced it. And this is why we got the information so quickly. Now, it may turn out that Omicron's actually been circulating in the world, you know, for a couple of months. I wouldn't be surprised if that were the case. But it was picked up by the South Africans, and the reason they brought it to WHO is to say this looks very unusual. Now, why is it unusual? Because it has these huge number of mutations, including on the spike protein. Many of those mutations we know are associated with increased transmissibility and also avoiding immunity by antibodies. So this is why it's of concern, because we can prepare, mm-hmm. we can alert the world, which is what WHO did. It doesn't mean that we're saying everybody panic, we're just alerting that this is a new development. While we collect more information about this variant, let us prepare ourselves. You know, a lot of countries dropped all public health measures completely. People were getting relaxed, thinking that the pandemic is over in many countries. Here's a reminder to us, the pandemic is not over. The virus is not done with us. We may be tired of the virus. So that is the reason, that's the message we're trying to send. Let's step up all of those measures that we know work and use them wisely, use them appropriately, and also look at equity.